The ice sports at the Winter Universiade took place in Granada in Spain. The first figure skating gold went to Germany's Peter Liebers. The 26-year-old applied sciences student from Berlin captivated the spectators at the igloo. He'd finished eighth in Sochi. Now, after breaking his shoulder last September, he was back to perform his Olympic program. Liebers took the title ahead of Japan's Takahiko Kozuka and Russia's Artur Kaczynski. The pair's gold medal going to Yu Xiaoyu and Jin Yang. The Russians Kristina Astakhova and Alexei Roganov took silver, with Vanessa James and Morgan Sipra claiming the bronze for France. In ice dancing, Charlina Ginar and Marco Fabri of Italy were the best. The spectators loved it. They took the gold. In second place, the Spanish dancers, Sara Hurtado and Adrian Diaz. And third, Frederica Testa and Lukas Scholli from Slovakia. In 2012, the Russian skater Elena Leonova was the silver medalist at the World Championships in Nice. Here in Granada, she struck gold. May Berenice Mitre of France was second, and another Russian, Maria Artemieva, took the bronze. On to the curling, and the Canadian women meeting the reigning champions from Russia. The gold medal game, a tight encounter, but finally the Russians coming through to retain their title. They are a very experienced team. Switzerland taking the bronze after defeating Sweden 8-7. In the men's final, Norway were the surprise champions. In the final, they beat the Russians 7-6. The bronze went to Great Britain after winning against Sweden 7-4. In the spectacular sport of short track speed skating, the South Koreans have carved out quite a reputation, and they collected a total of 12 medals in Granada. Park Se-yong is among the best in the world, so no surprise when he won the 1500 meters and the 1000. And the Korean women made it a clean sweep in their 1,000-meter race. Kim Alang capturing gold to add to the gold she won in the 1,500-meter race. She finished in front of Lee Yong-byul and Son Hak-yong. In the women's 3,000-meter relay, China took the gold, beating Korea and Canada. As for the men, it was a 5,000-meter relay, and China again ahead of Russia and France in third place. Ice hockey, and this the women's gold medal game. And the Russians against the Canadians. Second period, Anna Shokin scoring first for Russia. Into the third, and once again, Anna Shokin was the scorer. 2-0. Valeria Pavlova made it 3, and gold for the Russians. No score for the Canadians, so they would take the silver. Bronze to Japan, who beat China 4-1. And so to the final event of the 27th Winter Universiade, the men's ice hockey final, and a clash between two nations who'll welcome the Winter Games in 2017 and 2019, respectively, Kazakhstan and Russia. The Russians opening in the score in the first period, and a few minutes later, a shot from Igor Krivchenko would make it 2. Russia in the hunt for their 6th Universiade triumph since 1993. Time for Alexander Torchenyu to make his name. This was the second period, and Russia increasing their lead to 3. It was Kazakhstan's second final in a row after losing in Trentino to Canada 2 years ago. Renat Safin got a goal for them, but again, they'd leave the games as silver medalists. 3-1, the final score. celebrations for the Russian team in the final event of the Universiade.
No, it was not easy because Kazakhstan had a lot of moments. They might score a lot of goals, you know. But our keeper did a very great job. A lot of important saves.
So yet another goal for Russia, silver to Kazakhstan, Canada taking the bronze, beating the Czech Republic 6-2. And the final medals table, a total of 56 for Russia, including 20 golds, Korea winning 16 medals, and Kazakhstan 11. At the closing ceremony, Claude-Louis Gallien, the FISU president, passing the flag to the delegates of the city of Almaty in Kazakhstan, which will host the 28th Winter Universiade in 2017. The 2015 Winter Universiade has seen events take place in two countries, Slovakia and Spain. In total, 2,400 athletes from 540 universities had come together to experience a few days in their life that they will never forget.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders,